2016 kickoff. The motto was One Life, Live Them, honoring those who are multi-talented. Alright? Deejay Premier is the honored producer today. Charlamagne will be up here talking to Deejay Premier in a matter of minutes. Some noise. So make some noise for the Remy Mark Producer Series, please. Thank you. Now y'all sound like a crowd that's drinking Remy Martin on the house. Now y'all sound like that. In case you don't know, I go by the name of Jay Clax. I want to introduce your judges for a minute. The judges are over there. Judges? Judges? Okay. First and foremost, my man Steve Ray across the country. Give it up for my man Thea. And giving it up for Reeves, the only lady judge here. She is with Sony. She is the marketing brand person over at Sony. She markets Sony and brands together. Give it up for the only lady in the building, Reeves, please. So now what we do, I need y'all to come on to the stage or whatever so y'all can see, please. My man Willie Waters, give it up for my man Willie Waters, please. Come on, man, step up on the stage. Let's see it, ladies and gentlemen. Give it up for Willie Waters, please. This is Willie Waters' first track, ladies and gentlemen. Give it up for my man Javinci, please, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this is Javinci. Shout out Deux, the kid. He was here early before the whole thing even opened. He had a look on his face like he was ready, man. Give it up for Deux, the kid. I need to hear some noise. The kid's first track.
Fellowship foes, and you left out in the cold. Is it back to charge your motherfuckers? 11 for rolling essays, Latinos and Chimays, down by Pico with Federico. I answer all y'all questions, but then y'all got to go. Now the question I ask you is how bad you wanna know. Black. Motherfuckers can't rhyme no more, about crime no more, time no more, cause I'm so raw, my flow exposed holes that they find in yours. Wasn't for me, niggas still be dying for whores, but I hate when a nigga sit back, admiring yours, young blood, you better get that.
If you're new to this, you know every week or every other week, we get some of the hottest producers in the city, the tri-state area, and we listen to who's next. But the thing I like about it the most is that we get to sit down and chop it up with some of the OG legend producers of the game, people that have provided the soundtrack to my life, so I know they provided it for yours. And we got my man DJ Premier in the building today. Make some noise for DJ Premier, y'all.
If you can't come back.
Okay. One question I always wanted to ask you, Premier, man. A lot of people may or may not know, you was actually born in Houston, right?
Yes.
And raised in, I think it was like Prairie something?
Prairie View is a suburb outside of Houston.
Okay.
I was born in Fifth Ward, shout out to the Ghetto Boys, which is the most known region, you know, musically.
Absolutely.
And I know, shout out to the whole Rap-A-Lot family, that we know them from way, way back. And yeah, my father is an instructor taught biology. My mother's an art teacher, so they're both educators. And my father got a job at the college, Prairie View Random University, which is one of the historically black HCBU colleges. And HBCU colleges, pardon me. And I went to school there. And my grandfather lived in Bed-Stuy, so when I used to come to New York every summer with my sisters and my family, I really got a taste for New York at a young age. So by the time I was like 13, I said, this is what I want to do.
I always wondered, how did a brother from down south end up crafting the soundtrack for New York? Because, I mean, you could have went the other way and been doing Chopped and Screwed music.
Yeah, well, what it is at the time, Chopped and Screwed was brand new. Shout out to DJ Screw, rest in peace to him. I knew him when they used to sell their tapes just in a local store in the hood, and only the streets knew about it before it got to where it became a thing where you even get producers to do your album that way. So Screw hadn't even come out yet. It was Captain Jack, it was Steve Fournier, it was R.P. Cola, who was actually one of the top DJs who taught me how to scratch.
Gotcha.
And then from there, I just kept going further and further with it.
Did you know that you was actually crafting the sound for New York at the time?
Yeah, absolutely, because at that time, you wanted to get acceptance from New York before anything else.
It's interesting that you say that, because I would think that it would affect the sound maybe a little bit.
I think it's based on the fact that I was brought up on a lot of music before hip-hop, so there was no rap when I was a kid. So I'm 50, so, you know, I didn't have any rap. So my appreciation is so wide, from rock to punk to new wave to jazz, blues, Zydeco, soul. You know, when we used to go to the record store, it didn't say R&B in the record bin, it said soul.
Yeah.
You know, so now it says R&B and soul is not there. So that kind of tells you something. The music's gotten a lot of watered down.
Are you stingy with your beats, like as far as like new artists? Because you worked with legends,
right?
The Biggie, the Jays of the world. Yeah. Are you stingy when these new guys be like, they want something?
No, I work with any artists of any, even the new generation. They just got to still step to my world, do what they do, and let's still rock out.
Like, who knew inspires you and makes you be like, oh shit?
New, I definitely like Boy Wonder. Love Justice League, but they kind of been around in our underground world. So, but shout to them because they're dope with their production. Jaleel Beats, I like what he does. Who else? Off the head, the other ones that I'm watching that's more new. I love what 40 does with Drake.
Wow.
I mean, I've seen all the interviews where he said I influenced his style, and his stuff sounds nothing like a Premier beat. So that's a beautiful thing that my influence made him still form his own lane of sound.
Do you think the DJs getting phased out in hip hop? The one thing I loved about your production is when you would put the scratches in,
right,
with the vocals, like I'm so ghetto.
Yeah.
You think the DJs getting phased out as far as that aspect?
Not in the underground world that I still love to hear. That's why I do my radio show every Friday night on Sirius XM, because we do, it's called Live from Headquarters. We only break underground boom bap style music. So all the stuff that's on terrestrial radio, it doesn't fit my format, so I don't play it. Because right, you can just turn the dial and it's gonna come on. Now I still listen to the radio, your station and the other one. But with what we do, we want to have a lane that doesn't do what y'all are doing, so people can have other choices to go through. And at the end of the day, music is spread like it was back in the day, where you got to know where to find it.
And the first winner of the Remy Martin Producer Series, my man Soultronics. Give it up for my man Soultronics. All right. He won 2015. He was the first to do it, ladies and gentlemen.
Gay. Yo, it's year two. I was a part of the first year. I loved it. I'm here again. Yo, Remy, salute. Y'all definitely do your thing. The best producers come out here. Shout out to Premier. Love it.
Okay. All right. So listen, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to hear the winner of the kickoff of the 2016 Remy Martin Producer Series? I'm sorry, go ahead. Okay.
Yeah, shout out to Remy, shout out to Sean C's, all these judges, Jay Clax, Charlamagne Tha God, thank you. This was an amazing series last year. We had a lot of success last year. This man has done a lot. We've had a lot of producers have their eyes and ears, and this year is even bigger and better. So I know that this is the kickoff, but y'all really need to stay tuned for the rest of the summer.
Yeah. Shout out to the homie Jay Claxton. Shout out to Sean C's for having me. Thanks for all the beautiful people that came out. We're gonna keep doing this. Me rapping the judges, we all gonna keep coming out on Saturdays, Sundays, whatever y'all need us. We're gonna take this on. We're going on tour, right? Right, Sean? Sean, we taking this on the road, right? Let's go. We're gonna take it on the road too. Jay, let's go.
All right, so ladies and gentlemen, you ready to hear the winner of the kickoff of the 2016 Remy Producer Series, right?
That's a little better.
And y'all drinking Remy Martin for free. This doesn't happen, okay? This doesn't happen. But by unanimous vote, the winner of the kickoff of the 2016 Remy Martin Producer Series
is of the Remy Martin Series.
Drum roll. New Oldie Kid.
You know what I'm saying? This is happy birthday day. Thank you for Remy Martin, you know, doing this event. You know, I just keep God, Earth's supposed to be in church right now, so I'm about to leave and go to church. But they know I'm here. So, but yeah, I want to thank all of y'all. Y'all guys vibing with me. I appreciate it. You know, thank you for your feedback.
Absolutely.
You know, DJ Premier, you just gave me like the greatest, you know, boost for the day.
I need your number. Hey, Rob said you coming to Universal on Monday, man. He got you coming to the office. I think I'm setting up a meeting at Atlantic Records too. DJ Premier said.
No, yeah,
he's
coming to Sony. Sorry. Back up.
Hey, listen, once again, give it up for New Old King, ladies and gentlemen. The winner of the kickoff of the Remy Martin Producer Series 2016 premiere set. I was talking in mid-conversation and his beat came on and I stopped talking and asked, who was that, man? That gotta be the ultimate compliment. Alright?
Should've hit the play start and just let it roll. Alright, here we go. Can you turn it up a little bit?
Who that for? That's just something to play with?
I can't say the name yet, but...
Sound like Jadakiss.
No.
Kiss on
but yeah, Kiss would kill that. Shout to Jadakiss and the whole D-Block.
You didn't do nothing on the new Locks album?
He reached out. So they're just getting started. But shout to everybody. Sheet, Styles. I love how they're still just... It sound like Locks, you know what I'm saying?
You don't seem like the type to mail in beats. Like you want to be in studio with the artist.
Yeah. Because when I finally got my opportunity to do it, we had to just go in with the artist, and the label pushed for that back then. They were like, go to dinner with them, go hang out, find a way to vibe, and just bring us back a record. They weren't all in the way and nothing like that. They were like, bring us back a banging record, and that's what we would do.
So when you used to put those scratches in songs like Biggie kicking the door, that was like y'all in the studio and him saying, this is what I want.
Oh yeah, well, sometimes, you know, either way, either I'll come up with the scratch, Biggie come up with the scratch, Jay, and I'll experiment. If I can make it fit, I use it.
What's your memories of those early studio sessions?
Just the fun of seeing something start from just a sample, moving the needle around on a record, and the next thing you know, you have a whole full jam, and then you hear everybody in the street playing in their cars, which is still my way of making it. I make it for the boombox and a loud sound system.
Angie Martinez tells a great story in her book about how I guess you did the instrumental for
Crack Commandment. Yeah, it was a promo for her.
Yeah.
Me and Jay Rue. It's called the Hot 5 at 9 because I used to play the Hot 5 records at 9 o'clock. So back then, Angie was like the biggest personality because she was new. Everybody liked it. The youth liked it. The adults liked it. It was just Angie. So everybody that was hot were making promos for her. And she used to play them on the regular. So it was like, we got to make one. And J-Ru the Damager was popping real big at the time. So we were like, let's make her one as well. And then Big and them heard that and was like, can we make a song out of it?
I always wondered, Biggie and J-Ru had slight issues.
Yeah, they did.
Was that one of the reasons? Like,
In the early stages, everything was love. It was all love, yeah. We used to all hang out together, bug out, Kim, the whole Junior Mafia. And then when the One Day record came out, and he talked about the state of how he saw hip-hop at that point, he was speaking from the perspective of how we see it right now. And of course, names were named, but one thing I gotta say about Puff, is after all the tension and everything went down and we did the kick in the door record and there was a little tension in that session and then it got really cool, he said one thing in front of everybody that was in that room. He said, at least we were man enough to say the name of everybody on there without subliminally saying it, you know. He said, at least they said my name. I got to respect that.
Absolutely.
So, shout to the whole bad boy, man. And everything's love now, you know. So, we see everybody. Everything's good. We're back to working together and everything.
Absolutely. Now, you worked with that holy trinity of New York hip-hop, Biggie, right. Jay-Z, and Nas.
Right.
Who was your favorite?
I gotta say all three in three different ways though, because Nas, I was turned on to Nas by Lars Professor, and he's called the Rapper Nas. Yo, I got this kid, yo, named the Rapper Nas. And back then a lot of Queens guys used to call themselves that, like Big Noid is Rapper Big Noid. So that right there, when I heard the barbecue, I was blown away. And you know, I even put Big L in that same spot.
Do you miss being in a group? Rest in peace, Guru.
Yeah, absolutely, man. I miss being in. I mean, you know, shout to Royce the 5'9". You know, we did the Prime Project.
I wondered if that's why you did that.
No, that one right there was just an idea that was brought to us by Mike Herrard over at Shady and Goliath, and he said, "Why don't you do a project where you only sample one artist?" And just make beats off of that one artist's sound and make an album. Now, I've never done that, so it was a challenge because I like to dig from 20, 30 different records.
Yeah.
And I'm just going from Adrian Young's catalog. He gave me all his instrumentals and said, do what you want. He gave me the stems. I was like, I don't want the stems. I want to hear the way you programmed or performed with your band, and I'm going to just chop into a premiere version of it. And then, boom, we had Prime.
So Guru probably never got mad at you when you did records with Jay and Big because of the fact you crafted stuff individually.
Right, right. Because even when we would do Big stuff or Nas and stuff or Jay stuff, when we did a Gangstarr record, I wanted to be as hot as their records because I'm in the group too, so I'm in those videos and on the cover.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I want those to have the same effect that it does, but the only difference is we weren't really a mainstream group, so we kept making sure the underground was fed. And our singles always work, you know, my Steez, Mass Appeal, Dwick, I'll Take It Personal, Ex Girl to Next Girl, Manifest. You know,
so what's next for you, Premier? You mentioned some of the artists. What's right around the corner?
I'm gonna be touring overseas next week for a couple of weeks. I'll be doing that, and then getting ready to get all these albums up and running. If you need to ever follow all of the stuff that's going on with Gangstarr's future and updated news and all of our merch, everything, you can go to premierewashere.com. We have our official Gangstarr store with all the official stuff. We have the Premier store. We have the X label, which is Guru's nephew, who has all Guru products. And we keep up with all the current stuff in social media. So it's premierewashere.com, and was is spelled W-U-Z, not W-A-S. premierewashere.com.
I always wonder, Danny, like old Guru vocals laying around?
We are in the works of obtaining a lot of things right
okay.
now.
Okay. So it might be one last Gangstarr.
It should be a lot of things in the future.
Okay.
Yeah.
Y'all make some noise for DJ Premier, y'all.
Thank you.